Hey everybody, and welcome back to the other 100 tiles. So we're on level 68, force your way through. And speaking of forcing our way through stuff, I got a funny story to tell you. Well, it's not really funny, it's not really a story. It's that right now I've got this weird pain in my neck, and I don't know what it is exactly. I think it's from a couple nights ago. I slept on my stomach, and how do we get through this? Here we go. I slept on my stomach, you know, and I do that a lot by accident sometimes. You know, I just go to sleep, and before I know it, I curled up into another position, and it's completely different. But this time, I think I had stretched my neck out so far that I, okay, that I pulled it, like, kind of a ligament or something. Like, I don't know what it is, but it's the strangest feeling. Like, I feel like I got this bump in my throat, and it just feels really odd, and it's super sore, and I've never had something that sore in that spot. It's not really, I should say, it's not really in my throat per se, it's more like in my chin. It's almost in my throat, like it feels like it's kind of going down each day, but I hope that's all it is. I guess we'll find out if it's still there in like a week or something, but as far as I know, that could be that's the only thing I can really think that it could be, because other than that, I haven't really done anything else weird with my neck lately. And, like, I don't have any sores in my mouth or anything like that, so I guess we're going to have to go around for this again. The bold route for this level is pretty ridiculous, I'm going to say, as you can probably imagine. And it was way more efficient than this one. Alright, there we go. Alright, so now we need to go and push this. Oh, I got an idea. Oh, I was gonna see if I can do headbanger rule on that and then not have to go all the way around. And then have to do it another trip, but that's alright. I need to work on my not being able to optimize during a let's play anyway. Alright. From here, I'm trying to remember this room, because this room is kind of unusual. I do remember that it's kind of unusual. You have to go outside like this. Okay, so when I push it there, it's going to go there, and then I can just follow it. Or not follow it, but go from the right, and then push it to the left. Okay, let's try that again. There we go. Now follow it. Okay, so we got this glider here, and where do we want him to go? We want him to go down to the bomb. Okay. So let's set this thing up here first. I think just doing that will be fine. Oh, can we beat him there? Yes, we can. Alright, that should do it. And then the next room just has exits. There we go. Force our way through. We forced our way through all that. And now we get to experience Dances with Tanks. This level, I'm not a big fan of it. It's a great idea, don't get me wrong. I like the idea. But I gotta be honest, this is one of those levels I feel like it would have been better as a segment of a, you know, more interesting level with a little bit more variety going on. That's just me, maybe. I think the other part of it is that I really don't like levels where you're just confined to this little tiny area. Primarily just because I think this is a game that lends itself well to levels that are nice and, you know, exploration-oriented. That kind of came out really terribly, but you know what I mean. Like, the original Chips Challenge did a good job of that, and a lot of levels in this set do a good job of that, but this one, you're just stuck in this tiny little hallway thing, and I don't know. It just feels so limited, and it could have been so much more and had other ideas involving dodging monsters in a confined space, or maybe increase the space a little bit and had something else, not just tanks. That's just me, though. Anyway, moving on to Utter Clutter. This is a really fun level. I love this level a lot. It's in CCLP 1. There I go again. Michael totally caught my saying CCLP 3 when referring to Elemental Park a few videos ago. But, whoops. No idea why I did that. Let's try it again. And this time we won't have to worry about wasting time up there. Alright, get all these keys, and now we'll be equipped to take on that whole section over there. like this. And so we're going to need to go over here and open these guys up and then collect these. And then we're just going to have to bring this block to that water space. This is a pretty straightforward level. The gimmick of it basically is everything is something other than floor. That's kind of what the whole game is here. Like, there's not one tile that begins as a floor tile. Alright, just wait there. I don't know why I did that. Alright, and now we get to go this way. Of course, none of those traps are really open yet. They correspond to the buttons we passed through earlier. But maybe this area will provide some answers. Alright, so there's a tank here. Get all our stuff. And we need to bridge that water space there, but first we gotta press all these buttons to get that yellow key. So you might be wondering, well, how do we get a block over there? Simple, actually. These aren't one-time use. We can get another block. And turn it around here. Alright. So this says, the slide below is for fireballs only. Make sure they're there before going through another red door. Alright. Trying to remember. Yes, I think we're supposed to go over here to this part, because we had a glider get cloned with that button, which means that now we'll be able to just safely go through here without any problem and get some fire boots and then go to that fire area. The fire area that's up here, that is. And now we need to direct all these fireballs to the slide over there. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm thankful there's more than one block, because if I had to do this set of fireballs first, that would have been bad. But they're there now, and that means we can get another boot, since we got a yellow key under one of the blocks. Do-do-do-do-do. There we go. And now we can walk on ice. Always fun to walk on ice. I wish I could do that in real life, because in real life, like, whenever I go ice skating, I'm the most uncoordinated, unbalanced person ever. Part of that's just because I get nervous when it comes to balancing things. Like, if I have to stand on something really thin, or, you know, something like that. So, that doesn't help. I'm sure if I didn't have that fear, it would be a lot easier, but that's just something I struggle with. Alright, so now we can go over here to where all those bombs were, which I don't even know if I showed that earlier. Alright, there we go. And now we can go past the green door over here in the upper area. This is by far, well, not by far, but this is the longest level in the set in terms of build time. And I gotta say, for a long level, at least for me, it goes by really fast. I don't really think this feels very long at all, just because you're always doing something. There is a lot of back and forthing, but it's a pretty fun kind of back and forthing. Alright, so now we can go back and get ourselves that red key so we can get the flippers there. This is one of those levels that, for some reason, the build time, since this was in CCLB1, the build time took a long time to confirm. I don't know why, because it was a pretty, I think, a pretty simple one, even though at first I didn't quite get it. I made a silly mistake and totally missed something in the level. Something super obvious, too. Thankfully, this time, though, we were able to make it through without any troubles. Alright, let's zip back here and go to the exits. That was fun. And yes, this level is the reason why I cut off the video instead of going all the way to 10 levels last time. I knew this was going to be long, but anyway, it was fun. Repair the Maze 2.0. Oh boy, look at all the keys we've got here. Think carefully, you need every key. The force floors won't trap you. So we get one blue key, and two yellow keys, and two red keys. Let's just go and get what we can. And if we see something that obviously requires a key to get into, we'll use it. But we're just going to be careful for now. The one thing we can count on is that there is going to be only one blue door that we need to use our blue key on, so we need to keep that in mind. So far, though, this looks pretty straightforward. Nothing terribly crazy yet. It's nice that the hint told us that the force floors are not going to trap us, because that's one of those things that would easily worry me if I were playing this for the first time. Also, you don't need to get that green key there, obviously, since there are exits behind the chip socket as well. It's just something for fun in case you want to open all the green doors. Alright, here's an area where we can use a key. The question is, okay, we need to use it here. Because this is sealed off, and this over here is also sealed off, so both areas can be accessed only via that door. And down here, I think, is another dead-end area with some chips. I gotta say, this level is definitely long, or at least it feels kind of long since you're just going through a maze and whatnot, but it is pretty fun. I just kind of wish it didn't get placed right after a long level. It's actually not that bad, though. Alright, so let's go through here and see what we've got. We got to get that chip up there. How are we gonna get that one? Well, we cleared most of the red area, so I'm just going to go ahead and use my red key on that. My one red key. And, well, we need a yellow key for this at this point, so let's use that there. Leaving one more yellow key and our blue key, which is still unused. It's over here. Ah, this is sealed off. Alright. Well, at this point, it's just the blue key that's the mystery. It's another mystery! No one's gonna get that reference. How do we get over there? Oh, maybe that's where we use the blue door. Or blue key on the blue door. I feel like we just missed a bunch of stuff here. Oh well. Hopefully we can track it down without too much trouble, and hopefully no cookage here. Where are the remain? Oh, they're over there. Okay. Gotcha. Yeah, we didn't even explore this area, did we? If you look at this level in the editor, you'll see that the green doors form a perfectly diagonal line, which is really cool. Actually, I think in my bold route, I go to this area first so I can go onto those force floors and stuff. Wait, could I have gone to the... No, I couldn't have. That's where the blue door was. Anyway, we are done with that, and we can move on to Fission Mailed. Oh, this level is fun. For those who don't know what the title of this level is referencing, and I did not know what the title of this level was referencing when I first played this level, there's a level in one of the old Metal Gear Solid games where you have this boss fight, and the whole fight is structured such that you have to fail in the middle of it, and that's required for you to progress. And let's see what the hint says. It's impossible to trap yourself. Don't let that stop you from trying, though. So yeah, you can see here, I've not even used a single pop-up wall here. But basically, in the middle of the fight, instead of getting mission failed, the screen says fission mailed, and then you just continue the fight. And it's one of those things that's kind of gained a lot of notoriety in the video game world. And yeah, this level is kind of like easier than it looks from the original set. Really fun. I like it. But it's kind of become a video game trope since then. Like, if you've played the Phoenix Wright games, then they're kind of a master class in this idea, where you have to put yourself into a corner, and then all of a sudden someone's going to save the day. But it's that... Wait a minute. Did I forget the yellow key? I forgot the yellow key. There we go. And then at the very last second, someone bursts in the courtroom, or some witness steps forward or something and saves the day. You know, it's just one of those things. Alright. So let's get going. Let's go over here. You know, I've enjoyed doing this LP, but I've got to admit, I think my strength is, well, at least lately, is in blind LPs. I think blind LPs are kind of become my thing lately. Because, I mean, when you know, like, everything there is to know about the levels that you're playing, it just isn't quite as fun to LP it. It's fun to play it. I mean, I'm having a good time. It's just, it's a little bit different. Anyway, True Plinko is the next level. And this is a sequel to Plinko from earlier, except this one is kind of more like Jumping Swarm from CC1. I think it's a little easier, to be honest, than its predecessor, being Plinko, not Jumping Swarm. But maybe that's just me, I don't know. I kind of find this sort of walker dodging stuff to be pretty fun, especially when it's in an open area, not like a enclosed area, because we all know how well that turned out when I was playing... when I was playing Rock 1. Alright, there we go. Let's see how well we can do here. I kind of forgot what my route through this was. I wasn't even trying to get an optimal time when I played this level originally, just because it is an untimed level. But I had a pretty good route, though. Mainly just because I wanted to make sure I got to the exit before stuff like that happened. I wasn't really expecting it to happen here. I mean, this isn't exactly terribly hard. At least I don't think it's terribly hard. Do you guys think this is terribly hard? Maybe it is. It is, after all, at level 73, but I kind of like to think that that's the case just because we've gone through so many really super long levels lately. And it's not over yet. We still got a little ways to go. One thing is for sure, though, I know this route I'm taking is slower than my other route, just because that one ended this way faster, and I was almost done! Come on, level. Have a little mercy on me. Like, can you, like, send the walkers back to where they came from and have them bounce around up there for a while? Because that would be really super helpful. Alright, I don't think there's any more. I think we covered most of that when we were up there earlier. The route I'm taking right now is a little bit more akin to what I did originally, so this should hopefully get us home with a little bit more speed, and hopefully less in the way of dying. Oh, why did I go there? Why did I go there? I don't even know what this noise is. Okay. Let's try this again. This is fun, though. I know I'm sounding really grumpy, but this is fun. I'm having a good time. Alright. Four left. Good thing I stopped there, because that could have been really terrible. Okay. Whoa. 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 Yes! Did we beat our time? No, okay. Scatterbrained is the next level. Alright, so we got a bomb maze, and it looks like these fireballs are meant to follow predetermined paths set by the fire. They're kind of like a fuse, which I think was the idea behind this. This part kind of reminds you of nitroglycerin from Pit of 100 Tiles. Well, let's just kind of get our bearings and figure out what our objectives are, because I see lots of stuff here. Okay, we got some teeth there, and we're going to have to go through that teleport there to make that happen. Alright, I'm not feeling up to going through that right now. Alright, let's let that destroy the bomb. Okay, we need to get that tank button pressed, don't we? I think one of the fireballs destroyed a bomb blocking the tank button, didn't it? I guess I thought so. There was a tank button here. Yeah, there we go, right here. Looks like we got a bridge to through some water to get to that button. Man, so much stuff here. Alright, so what do we do with this block? Alright, so from here we can see that we're going to need to use the block on that trap button in order to hold it down, because if we pushed it, we'd be trapped. But we cannot push the block in this space, because then the block would be trapped. So we're going to come up with a really interesting route through this force floor gauntlet here. All right, let's see if we're up to the challenge. All right, so let's... Oh, I forgot that was the edge. Confound it. Why did I do... We're getting to that point where failures are going to be a little bit more of a thing, I'm guessing. I hate that, but you know how it goes. Why am I going there? I mean, we're going to come back there later, right? I'm just going to go ahead and do this now. I need to get this blue key, but I'm going to go ahead and just do this yellow key thing at the moment, because we're going to go back up there later on and all that good stuff, so... Okay. I think I did... Whoops. There we go. I did this the hard way. Oh, I miscounted the number of squares and I... Grr. Then I panicked and... Sorry, guys. I really am scatterbrained these days. I don't know what's going on with me, but for some reason, I'm just not all here. All right. Even when I'm telling these stories, like what happened with my neck and everything, I feel like I just can't tell stories the way I used to. Maybe it's fine. Maybe I'm just not giving myself enough credits. All right, let's open this up this time. Let's not do that. I believe that that's in the bold route, but we're not going for the bold time here. Okay, this time, go around. Then do this, I think. There. Okay, great. That's more like it. Now that's more like it, Mr. Wayne. Alright, let's go over here. Oh, we need a blue key, don't we? Well, thankfully we can now get to that blue key since the fireball blew up that bomb. Now let's do that. This way. And we got a nice toggle maze thingy. Sweet. Alright, ooh, and another trap button. Oh, this is the one that destroys that thing over there. And we're back here. Thankfully, we don't actually need to go through the... Why'd I stop there? Why'd I stop there? Ugh. I'm just doing awfully today. Sorry, guys. I'm really sorry. It's... I don't know why I'm just... not doing it, doing well today. I really don't know why. Alright, let's get our head in the game. Let's do this. We can't be down our luck. We gotta get our head in the game and get back into this. Okay, I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna do the daredevil method here. Alright. That was still a little slower than the ideal time, but still... Okay, we need to go back, don't we? There we go, okay. I'm trying to think if there's anything that's been going on lately that would be interesting to talk about that I haven't mentioned already. Other than the situation I'm trying to deal with that's been really heavy on my mind, I don't really know. Why'd I boost into the... Ugh. I cannot believe it. This is not indicative of how I normally play this game. Really, guys, I promise you, this is not indicative of how I normally play this game. I'm normally a little bit more cautious than this. I don't know why I'm just in a rush tonight. I should probably not record any more videos after this one tonight. I said that in the last video, and I went ahead with this one. But I probably shouldn't do any more just because I'm not in the right frame of mind for this right now. Wow! Okay. Okay. Come on. Come on, JB. You can do this. You can do this. And we haven't even gotten to the top half of the, or the top third of the level yet. I mean, this level is long. It is long. Okay. I keep forgetting that there are monsters over there when you get out of that teleport. That is... It's not really evil since there's not a monster there immediately, but still, boosting, man. We people who have to feel the need for speed, sometimes the game can be really punishing. Alright, let's go back and get that blue key. This time, I think we've got it. We don't need to go deal with these teeth anymore. We just have to go up here and do this business. Alright. I should probably turn on the AC here in the apartment. Maybe that's what's bothering me. Like, I don't have any air right now. Okay, there we go. Don't wait there or do anything silly like that. Alright, so we need to press that toggle button. But let's go up here for now. We haven't even explored this area yet. Alright. Got two blue keys. We need two blocks, so let's go and unlock this guy. And so let's get this first one here. We'll go down the line, why don't we? Alright, so this is pretty simple. All we have to do now is just keep unlocking a door that's two spaces away from the last door. And one more door up here. I think the other big thing that's been on my mind is that because Chips Challenge 2 is coming out at the end of this month, I really, really want to have pretty much all my projects squared away, and I've got so much planned. Wait a minute. Oh, right, I got the key over here. I had so much planned beforehand for the channel and whatnot. It's going to be quite a ride before Chips Challenge 2 comes out. I mean, I got to finish this set. I got the new Nancy Drew game coming out. I got this puzzle here I need to do by doing that. Haha. I think I alluded to this level earlier when we were doing another block-pushing puzzle. I was like, hey, that trick's going to come in handy later. What was the other thing I had? I want to finish up Chuck's Challenge because they recently, like, as in last November recently, released a new level pack for the game of official levels, and I really want to continue playing through the official levels of Chuck's Challenge. So there's that. And then there is Broken Age Act 2, because that finally got released. So I've got that to do as well. I mean, there's just so much. And then on top of that, I've got all the work, I got a bunch of work to do, and... Wait, did I blow up the bombs down there for the... No, I didn't. I was too fast. Boo for being too fast. Woo. There you go. Part of me thought there was a chip there. I don't know why I thought that. This is ultimately for this, so we can do this thingy again and go over here through this fourth floor madness to get one last chip. Shazam. Alright. Let's go back to the exit and get out. We've been here long enough. This level... I like this level, don't get me wrong. It's just... It's long. Alright, we'll continue with Switch Direction next time, guys. Thank you once again for putting up with me and my gameplay and everything. I know that I've been kind of on a bad streak lately, but I hope to correct that next time. So until then, take care, guys. I'll catch you on the flip side, and I really appreciate you guys watching this series and supporting the channel. It really does help. I'll see you guys next time.